Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. Hello, wonderful people. What we're going to do in this one is we're going to actually add these guides to our views so we can use that lovely 12 column grid and get started with our design. All right, let's go and do it. Okay, so now we're going to make our grids. Before you do, weirdly, if you move the artboard, the grids don't come along for the ride easily. Okay, so just get them kind of laid out how you want. Okay, it doesn't really matter how you've got your artboards. Okay, but I'm going to line mine up this way, maybe a little bit closer. Okay, now I'm moving it with the Artboard tool. Okay, it's this guy down the bottom here, moves your pages around. So first thing we need to do is grab our rectangle tool. Okay, click on this guy here. You might be stuck on the circle tool or rounded rectangle tool underneath. Grab the rectangle tool for me. Okay, in terms of the sizes, I want either a white fill or a none fill. Okay, so that's the center of the box, and this is the line around the outside, and I want this to be anything but something that we can see on a white background. So black works for me. Okay, and I'm gonna click, hold, and drag. And you can see mine's trying to snap. You can see it's pretty clever at trying to, like, you can see that little word that says intersect. Okay, if yours is not snapping to it, go to view and turn on this thing called Smart Guides, or Command U on a Mac or Control U on a PC. Okay, it's a really handy one to use, especially at this stage. So I'm gonna zoom in a little bit, remember? Command minus or Control minus. And I'm gonna draw a box across the whole thing. It's a bit of a faff. Okay, a little bit. So we've got one big box, and now what we're gonna do is we're gonna split it into columns. Okay, we find it under Object, and then down under Path, and then there's one that says Split into Grid. And this fun box appears. We don't want rows, okay, we want columns, okay, the up and downs. So we're gonna put it up to 12. Okay, and in terms of the widths, okay, we're not worried about that. What we're worried about is the gutter. So the columns you saw at the beginning there, there's gaps between them, okay? And there's a really common size for them. You might have to check with your developer or the CMS that you're using. Most of the time, the gutter between them, okay, is on each side of the column is 15 pixels. So, but that's either side. When they're next to each other, they add up to 30, okay? And so there's our gutter set to 30 pixels, and we're gonna click 12. I'm gonna make sure we turn on Add Guides. I'm gonna turn on preview so you can see what we're talking about. That would have been easier. Okay, so you can see I've got 15 pixels and then 15 pixels either side of these columns, so together they make 30. Okay, let's click okay. So now what I wanna do is, what I really want is I want to grab my black arrow, okay, my selection tool, and I click these guys that got made. Okay, then I'm gonna right click them and go to ungroup. Okay, so it gets rid of, because I don't want this horizontal one, I just want the columns, not these rows here. So what we can do now is we can go through and actually I'm gonna select these guys here. And if you have used Illustrator before, you're thinking, oh great, they're guides. They're not, they're kind of just like physical lines that are on the thing used as guides. What I need to do now is I'm gonna kind of lower them down just so they kind of snap to the top there. Okay, so they poke down the bottom here. And what I'll do is I'll extend them down the bottom. So I've got them all selected. The easiest way to select them all, okay, if you are new, black arrow, select all just the tippy tops of them. Because we've ungrouped them, it's left these guys behind. So I'm gonna drag them down so it matches up at the top. And then down the bottom here, okay, I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna drag these down quite far because I have no idea how long this page is gonna be. And it's easier to do it here when I drag it down. Okay, so I've got all those done. I've got them still selected. Don't worry, that one's darker than the others. I clicked it by accident. Still gonna work. And we're going to go down to view and we're gonna go to guides. And there's one in here that says make guides. I know it feels like we've done that already, don't worry. Okay, those are actual proper guides now. So now what I can do is I can go to my view and I can go to guides and go to, yours might be by default already locked. So if it says unlock guides here, don't click it, okay? But yours is probably like mine and it says lock guides and it means I can't move them now. I was able to select them, but now I can't. Now all this junk that's left behind, there's quite a bit of it, gone. That is how you turn it into a 12 column grid. Okay, you might have to rewind and play this thing through a couple of times. It did for me when I first started doing it, so don't sweat it. That is how you set up your columns. Now, what we're also gonna do is I'm actually gonna, because I hate designing right to this edge here. Okay, so what I do is I grab my artboard, is I extend it out a little bit, just so that I've got some kind of like play area. Okay, it just means that it's hard to design within that little box and you're meant to butt everything up to this edge and it just doesn't look right. I'll show you what it looks like here. You can see here, I've got this area here and it's kind of white space. I know it's not always there, but it's often there. So I kind of expand it here as a designer just so I can see some extra bits. I know that the width is still, you know, between these two guides is 1200, which is perfect. Okay, and a little kind of like quick tip for you is if you drag this out, say this guy on the left, right here, if I hold down my Option key on Mac or the Alt key on a PC, you can see it does both sides. Just gives myself a little bit of wiggle room. Now, even though I say don't move them, okay, we're gonna move them along. There's no guides on them yet, so we're okay. All right, so it's step and repeat for the rest of them. If you've, so I'm gonna do the next one for tablet, and we'll do this one together. So I'm gonna drag it out, we'll make it a little bit faster. We're gonna go to object, we're gonna go to path, we're gonna go splinter grid, and I'm gonna say, let's make 12 of these guys, okay? And I kind of talked about it earlier, 12 is just too many. So I cut it down to 6. Because it's dividable by 12. You can put 12 in there. I like 6 to cut it down. The gutter, okay, between these guys is still going to be 30. Okay, and I'm gonna click okay. No, I'm gonna say make guides. I'm gonna click okay, and I've got this. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select him. I'm gonna right click him and say ungroup. Then I'm gonna click just the tippy tops of these guys, and I'm gonna lower them down. And then I'm gonna say view. I'm gonna go to guides, I'm gonna say make guides, and I don't have to go and lock them again, they're all locked by default, okay? It's kind of like an overall, you don't lock particular guides, you lock all guides on all pages. So if I go to guides now, you can see I can unlock them, but I can't lock them because they're already locked. So I can select all this stuff, bye-bye. Okay, grab the artboard tool, hold down your Alt key on a PC or Option key on a Mac, drag the sides out, just give myself a little bit of a playroom. Okay, and we're gonna do the next one. Now, I want you to go off and do the next one by yourself. Okay, you can pause the video and see if you can give it a crack. I'm gonna do it here. Okay, just cause. And you can fast forward to the next movie if you've got the idea. So I've got this one selected. Doesn't really need to go to the bottom. That's my OCD. Okay, and remember, we're gonna go to Object, and we're gonna go down to Path, and we're gonna go down to Split to Grid. In this case, we're just gonna use 2, okay? I could put 4 if you prefer, if you're gonna do some kind of cool things in here on mobile. I'm not, okay? I'm gonna put a gutter in of 30. I keep clicking okay, you're gonna do it as well. Make sure you click add guides. Forget about that every time. Click okay. Cool, so we've got our pretend guides. We're gonna select them, right click them. So I'm using my black arrow, go to ungroup. Okay, I'm gonna select just the tippy tops of them, grab one of them and drag it down. Okay, so it lines up to the top. Great, and now we're gonna do, I'm gonna make them a little longer. I forgot to do it for these guys, so I'm gonna pay for that later. It's all right. Drag these down, now we go to view, we go to guides, and we go to make guides, and then it's already locked, so we can grab all this junk that's left over, hit delete, and we now have a 12 column grid across them all that we've kind of snuckily just done 6 and 2 on these ones here. I'm gonna use the artboard tool on this. You and just go out a little bit, okay? And yeah, gonna hit save. All right, guys, and that's how to make a 12 column grid in Illustrator. If you are lazy like me, you will download a template and it will be this right here, okay? I'll leave it in the exercise files. I will call it 12 column grid in Illustrator template or something like that. It'll be in there. You can just open that and yeah, go forth with that one. How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.